Hi, and welcome to TV My Husband Hates. I'm Kat Sims.
And I'm Reagan Kempton.
And we are reality TV addicts.
Addicts, aficionados.
Ooh, I like that. Experts.
Experts.
Basically, we know our shit when it comes to reality TV.
100%.
Hi, Reagan.
Hey, Kat. How was your week?
It was good. Do you know what, though? I've been looking forward to this all week. I'm so excited.
I have, too. I've, like, been in my head. I was like, can I just record every day of the week?
I know. It's like, do you know, I think we might get to a point in, like, 11 billion weeks when we're like, oh, fuck, we've got to do the podcast. But right now, I am loving every minute.
Me too. And I mean, A, it's talking about like one of my favorite topics, but it's also getting to chat with you. I think this is the most we've chatted since I've been away.
It's lucky because we've been such good friends that when obviously kids and work and marriage, we haven't really had that much chance to chat as regularly as we'd like. But now I feel like I'm kind of getting sick of you.
Already? This is like the first episode.
I know. That's obviously not true. But, yes, it is our first episode, although to be 100% honest, we're not entirely sure whether we're going to be using it because we're still waiting for branding.
No, I know. You can't rush the creative process by any means. So, yeah, right. This could be the first this could be the first episode, or maybe next week will be the first episode. Either way.
Who knows? Anyway, I'm glad that we are recording because I think that this week has kind of been a good one on the reality TV circuit.
It's been an amazingly good week. I think we've got a new show to talk about this week because The Real Housewives of Dallas started on Wednesday.
We've got a new character because there's a new guy on the block in Million Dollar Listing New York.
Oh, that's true. He's exciting.
Although I've honestly forgotten his name already.
Yeah, we'll look it up.
We'll look it up or we'll make it up. We'll give him a new name.
Yeah. No, he seems exciting. So shall we just dive in then?
Yeah, we could just dive straight in. So I think we, as you know, well, you probably don't know, it's not a podcast that we are claiming to be mega professional, are we?
No, not at all. I mean, this is literally, I think, the third time we've recorded together.
And literally in our 5-minute, what we very grandly called the production chat, beforehand, we realized that actually going forward, it might be prudent for us to make notes on what we've watched. Because we were like, can we remember what we've just been watching?
Hence, forgetting the guy's name, which has no basis on him as a person or his role on the show. It's just literally left my brain.
And also, I mean, it's not the first one we forgot. Because before we would check it, I was like, oh, what's the guy's name, the drunken guy's name on Below Deck Med? And Reagan was like, oh, man. And I was like, it's Curtis. And if it's not Curtis, it's something like Curtis. Anyway, we figured it out. It's Travis, which is obviously exactly like Curtis.
It's the same. It ends in is.
Yeah. And so anyway, what we're trying to say is that we're totally pro. We know everything about reality TV. And yes, I mean, that might not be true, but we'll keep going forwards anyway. We'll plow on regardless.
Right. And something that we've also just talked about in our tiny little production meeting was I think we're going to start chronologically. So let's go with what was on Sunday. So I think that takes us to The Real Housewives of Potomac.
Yes, it does. And we are nearing the end of this season. Like we've jumped into this podcast. I think we maybe have a couple more episodes before the reunion start, or maybe even reunion next week.
Yeah, the finale is next week, and then the reunion will be after that. So
I guess we're discussing the penultimate episode tonight.
Yeah, and I guess we haven't even talked about whether we're going to discuss reunions or not.
No,
another meeting.
We're so professional.
Well, or maybe
yeah,
we'll.
You probably should, because I think there's probably. I always find the reunions fun. Like I always find there's a lot to talk about in there.
Yeah, I agree. I think you get a lot of reveals that you didn't actually know happened, kind of behind the scenes stuff, and then, you know, kind of get like their hindsight, which I think is always kind of cool.
Yeah, because we'll be talking about the episodes, and it's always quite nice when they go to reunions to see if they thought the same as we did. Because obviously the whole plan of this podcast is that eventually we take over from Andy Cohen.
Yes, that is the master world domination plan of this podcast.
Yeah, exactly. So I feel like we need to like cut our teeth on kind of dissecting the reunions at this stage, so that when it comes to them handing us the Bravo mantle, we're already prepared and ready.
You know what? I just had an idea pop into my brain, but I think we should maybe do a mini-sode on the reunions where we just focus on that reunion and have a chat. You guys let us know what you think. If that way, if you're into the show, you can tune in for the reunion. But if you're not, yeah.
Also, excuse my very excited interruption there. We could do like watch parties with the reunion.
Yeah, I think we should do that, and maybe even with the series finale or the season finale, not the series finales.
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes, we can figure that. Maybe that's a little way down the line, because clearly we're still trying to get to grips with simply recording the podcast. So maybe once we've done that, we can move on to getting super tech.
Yeah, and you guys write us in. Let us know what you think or what you would like to hear, because this is obviously not just the two of us having this conversation. It's all of us having this conversation. So email us at hey@tvmyhusbandhates.com and let us know. Minisodes, yay or nay. We could also just do polls in the group, too. We'll throw it all out there.
I mean, at least we hope we're not the only ones listening to this. We really hope that there are other people out there.
Yeah, I mean, I hope there's a tribe of diehard reality TV fans out there just listening and screaming out at us if we've gotten things wrong or that they totally disagree with us. I want to picture people in their cars yelling at us.
Yeah, me too. And also, it's one of those things people get kind of diehard about. Like, they know who they like, they know who they don't like, they know what they feel about stuff. It is a kind of TV that you start screaming and shouting at the TV when you're watching. So feel free to scream and shout at us when you're listening to it in your car or, you know, on your run. Maybe not on your run. It might be weird if you're just screaming and shouting while you're running.
But you could easily run and laugh at us. Like, that doesn't look weird at all.
No, that's fine. You know me, Ring. I'm all for talking to myself. Like, I do love a good talking to. Okay, so let's start then with Real Housewives of Potomac. We're coming to the end of the season. In general terms, what have you felt about this season? Because it's kind of, I think Potomac is a little bit off. It's not the most well-known of the franchise.
Yeah, I know personally, I came to it rather late. Like, I've really only watched it the past 2-3 seasons, which I think I missed like the first two. I could be 100% wrong about that, but anyways, that's what I'm going with. But I really like it. I like the dynamic between the ladies. I didn't think I would. It was a slow burn for me to get like really into it.
Yeah, I think they've always got, all of them always have like that one character, like whether it's Bethany Frankel on New York or Vicky Gumball, whatever her name is, I forget, on the OC, who isn't there anymore. But I think in this one, there's a couple of those. Like, there's Giselle, who is batshit crazy, but man, do I love her. Like, she is, like, I wouldn't want to get on the wrong side of her, but she's another one, a little bit like Ryan Serhant from Million Dollar Listing, that has really done some growth throughout the four seasons.
Absolutely. I really like her friendship dynamic with Robin. Like, I feel like they are real friends outside of the show. I can't always say that about all the characters on all the different franchises, but I feel like they have a real friendship. And I think we saw that in this episode when Robin's like, "You hurt my feelings, man." And she's just like, "Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry." Like, I felt like that was a super heartfelt moment and kind of an insight to the fact that they really are friends.
Yeah, and that Giselle has really grown, because she never would have just like handed over an apology willy-nilly before kind of going to see her therapist, whose name I forget. Again, I'm going to do a little bit more research and take a few more notes for the next one. But I really like the way that she talks about him, and she's like been very open about that therapy. And you know me, there's nothing I love more than a therapy session. So it's cool to see her go through that process and come out the other side less of a dick.
Absolutely. I think for me, my benchmark of human growth is being able to apologize to people, like taking it on board that you were a dick and being like, you know what? I was an asshole. I'm sorry about that. I will do better next time, and actually do better, not be like the perpetual sorry machine that, not to like bring in another franchise that we see from Ramona, who just like hands out sorries like it's raining at the strip club. But I like to see like an actual real life apology and then like some change.
Yeah, me too. But talking about Robin, I feel like I really want to discuss her relationship.
Yeah, I think it's really strange. And I don't know if it's because I didn't watch the first couple seasons. I don't even know if she's in them. Like, again, poorly researched chat headed your way.
She is. She's like an original.
Okay, so I think she and her husband were married. Then they got a divorce.
Yes, because he was having affairs left, right, and center.
Ah, okay. That makes sense to me.
So to fill you in, so they divorced, but they never... I mean, tell me what you think of this, but I'm not a big fan of keeping kids in the dark about shit, but they never told their kids about the fact that they were divorced or that they were separate. Anyway, they continued to live together. And I think they continued to live together when they absolutely were not together, but they kind of grew back together and living together, and eventually I think they've kind of found their way back to each other, which I mean, I really honestly want to believe in that as a fairy tale ending, but I just can't quite get on board with it. And it isn't that either of them are particularly shady. In fact, I really like Robin. It isn't that even I think her husband's that shady, because from what I've seen of him, he's really nice, but I just don't understand how that's possible.
Yeah, I mean, coming from a family of very divorced people, pretty much everybody.
Rather than just slightly divorced.
Yeah, no, they're majorly divorced.
like 100% divorced.
Right. I mean, my parents my parents couldn't help but be very open about it. We all knew what was wrong and what was going on. As kids, probably not the full extent of what it went through, but I don't know. I mean, on some level, I understand not telling very, I don't know. I want to say, like, I kind of understand it. Like, if they are, like, doing the work and doing therapy and trying to really work it out together, I mean, if that was kind of the thing that happened, like, stuff happened, they decided to get a divorce, but then still wanted to work on it. I don't know. I guess it's totally confusing. Never mind. Like, why get a divorce?
No. Here's the thing. Why keep it from the kids and then put it on a massive motherfucking television show?
Right. I mean, obviously that discussion has probably had to happen again, because aren't they talking about getting remarried with the kids involved?
Yeah. So, I mean, all of this stuff. I mean, I guess the thing is, I like Robin and I trust that she's a great parent and I'm sure that they've handled it. But it just from the outside looking in, it's a weird setup. And here's my stance. I really, really hope that it is the fairy tale ending and that they've just been super mature and modern about it and it's all worked out. And I really hope he doesn't dick her around again. I think that's where I'm coming from. I think I'm kind of protective of Robin.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think I get that. I think as women, we're all very protective of other women who have been scorned or hurt. And we kind of want to like just be there for them and be like, no, you don't need them. Like, go off and do your own thing. But I don't know. Relationships are so much more complex than I think what we can see on the reality shows. And it is also up to them on what we see and what we don't. So who knows? Maybe there's loads of therapy behind all of this stuff. And who knows what else is going on in lives? Not saying that that's an excuse to cheat or anything like that. But I don't know. Like, I'm in your camp. Like, I hope it works out for them. I hope their kids are great. And this is a new chapter for them. But we'll see.
We'll see. Anyway, how beautiful did the Bahamas look in this
episode? Oh my gosh. I want to be there right now. I was like, why can't we just record the podcast from the Bahamas? I mean, not right.
Not?
Yeah, okay. Not right now. They're going through a terrible hurricane at the moment, but
oh yeah, of course they are. And
they've been decimated.
Do you know, just to keep this all on track and in one thing, on Joao from Below Deck has just launched a huge campaign to help the people in the Bahamas suffering from the after effects of the hurricane. So if you are interested in helping and you want to do everything that you can, go and check out Joao's Instagram account from Below Deck. He's talking all about it. In fact, I caught a little snippet of Insta Ben, who is Chef Ben, doing a live with him this morning. So there's lots of stuff going on if you want to help in the Bahamas. I like that all tied up nicely.
Yeah, I was also going to say, research who you donate to as well. Like, make sure you're donating to people who give directly, not to massive organizations who are paying overhead. There are a lot of kind of grassroots people to donate to. And I think Joao's probably connected to one of them where all the help goes directly to the people who've been affected because they've been decimated. Water was crazy high and hurricanes are scary, man.
Yeah, I mean, I feel bad, like, how beautiful to live in the Bahamas, but it definitely comes with its risks. Anyway, listen, let's get back. Not that I am obviously playing down what happened in the Bahamas, but
right. We need to get back on track.
This is a podcast about hurricanes in the Bahamas. We would be on track, but we're not. We're way off track. So we're coming back to Housewives of Potomac and Crazy Katie.
Yeah, so she just up and booked it. I mean, I think there's a lot of things going on in her life during the time of filming that weren't shown on the show, but was kind of playing out in social media about custody of her kids and all this crazy stuff. And I think, I think she's a little fragile. Like I said, I didn't watch the show before, so I never saw her.
She was first, and she was like an original in season one, and she was bonkers then. And there is, I know she's going through some stuff and I know she's fragile and it's difficult and all of that, but pre the stuff and pre all of that, she's always had a touch of the bonkers about
right.
her. Like, she just beats to the march of her, no, marches to the beat of her own drum. I'll get there eventually.
Right.
So she's kind of one of those people that I never really warmed to as a character, and as much as I feel for her going through her stuff on the very shallow level of entertainment in terms of Real Housewives, I just find her kind of hard, like crazy to watch. Like, there's a lot going on for me.
No, I totally agree with you there. I don't think she kind of keeps her story straight. I think she's all over the place. I think she talks a lot of shit about everybody.
I know she's not drunk all the time, but it's kind of a bit like that. That she has that sober drunkenness about her. Do you know what
totally.
I mean? Like, there's always a little bit of me that's like, are you like secretly sniffing meth in the back room because there's something weird going? It's that kind of, she's kind of got the crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. She's a bit manic.
She's manic. Yeah. There's a lot. Anyway. So she just ups and left. But what I thought was really funny is that, so they wake up in the morning, she's not there. And they worry. I mean, I'm kind of like, well, didn't she just...
Please subscribe, rate, and review TV My Husband Hates wherever you listen to your podcasts. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram at TV My Husband Hates and join the Facebook group to keep the conversation going when the podcast ends. If Twitter's your thing, you'll find us at TV Husbands Hate. Theme music and production for TV My Husband Hates by Jimmy Sims.